There is so much confusion out there right now, and my hope is that this video will help to clear things up. Lots of people seem to think that we will soon see a return to normal, and that good times are just around the corner, but that is not true at all. In fact, I believe that things will become progressively worse in the months ahead. I don't know if we have ever seen a time when more major end-time signs were in the process of being fulfilled, and I expect global events to soon accelerate even more. It has been nearly a year since I first released Lost Prophecies of the Future of America, and I thought that this would be a good opportunity to go back and look at how events have progressed since that time. The following are 10 signs that major end-times events are in motion here in 2021. Number 1. Natural disasters. I spend several months warning about great natural disasters that are coming, and this year the instability of our planet has only gotten worse. The number of large earthquakes that we have seen so far this year has increased dramatically compared to last year, and Volcano Discovery says that 28 volcanoes are currently in the process of erupting. Recent eruptions in Iceland and on St. Vincent have made headlines all over the globe, and now scientists are carefully monitoring the largest active volcano in the entire world. Mauna Loa, the world's largest active volcano, covering half of the Big Island of Hawaii, was rattled by 34 small earthquakes on Sunday. Though only registering small magnitudes, scientists have warned citizens that the mounting seismic activity could signal that an eruption may be possible in the near future. Number 2. Civil unrest. We have seen endless rioting, looting and violence in major cities all over America. In fact, this week we have seen horrible riots in Minneapolis, Portland and elsewhere. When I first started warning that great civil unrest would come to America many years ago, a lot of people didn't take me seriously, but now nobody can deny what is happening. Number 3. War with Russia. Could Ukraine be the spark that begins the military conflict between the United States and Russia? At this moment, Russia has somewhere around 100,000 troops massed along Ukrainian borders, and the US is being warned to stay away from Ukraine. Russia warned the United States on Tuesday against sending warships to the Black Sea, urging American forces to stay away from the annexed Crimean Peninsula, for their own good, as the situation along Ukraine's border caused increasing concern in the West. The US Secretary of State, meeting with Ukrainian and NATO officials in Brussels, made it clear that the Biden administration, along with its allies in Europe, has Ukraine's back and considers Russia's ongoing military buildup in the region very provocative. The Turkish Foreign Ministry said on Friday that Washington had informed Ankara that two US warships would pass through Turkish waters this week to be deployed in the Black Sea. The deployment would come amid a significant escalation of the conflict in eastern Ukraine between Russian-backed separatists and Ukraine's forces, which have US and European support. Number 4. War with China. At the same time that a potential conflict with Russia is looming, tensions with China have risen to higher levels than we have seen in decades. At this stage, Taiwan has become the main source of contention, and on Monday the Chinese sent 25 military aircraft into Taiwanese airspace. China's People Liberation Army flew 25 warplanes into Taiwan's Air Defense Identification Zone, ADIZ, on Monday, its largest incursion yet as tension in the Taiwan Strait continues to escalate. According to Taiwan's defense ministry, the PLA warplanes 14 GN-16 fighter jets, 4 GN-10s, 4 H-6K bombers, 2 Y-8 anti-submarine warfare planes and 1 KJ-500 airborne early warning and control aircraft, entered the island's southwest zone on Monday. Number 5. War with Iran. We know that Iran and Israel will go to war at some point, and the attack that just happened on the Natanz nuclear facility has brought the two countries dangerously close to a shooting war. Iran has blamed Israel for a mysterious explosion at the weekend that knocked out power at its uranium enrichment facility at Natanz. Israel has not publicly said it was behind what Iran calls an act of sabotage, but US and Israeli media reports are quoting officials as saying it was carried out by Israel's overseas intelligence agency, Mossad. Iran has vowed to take revenge at a time of its choosing. Number 6. Rising food prices. In the video I warn of rising food prices, food shortages and global famines that will eventually develop. Well, food prices are definitely rising. In fact, I just posted a video about this entitled, "Food Prices Are Rising Aggressively," and even the corporate media is admitting that it is only going to get worse. Number 7. Economic collapse. Since the start of the pandemic, more than 70 million new claims for unemployment benefits have been filed in the United States, Approximately 4 million U.S. small businesses have permanently closed down, and millions more Americans have fallen into poverty. Yes, stock prices are still hovering near all-time highs and the rich are richer than ever before. But meanwhile, vast stretches of our major cities are starting to resemble post-apocalyptic wastelands. Homeless men lie on the sidewalk while others wearing blankets and rags loiter on a street strewn with garbage, feces, and drug paraphernalia along the notorious Kensington Avenue drag in Philadelphia. Video posted online on March 10 shows people living out of suitcases on the sidewalks in the area adjacent to the entrance to the Somerset train station along the Market Frankford train line while others openly brandish needles. Cardboard boxes with trash bags stacked on top of them lie feet away from the entrances to various pawn shops, check cashing stores, delis, and bodegas. Number 8. An increase in wickedness. Over the past several months, I have done numerous videos documenting rising crime rates and the moral decay that is eating away at our society like cancer. At this point, just about every form of evil that you can possibly imagine is absolutely exploding in our society, and some people are even spending lots of time and money to transform themselves into real-life monsters. Rico Ledesma, 41, who lives in Brazil with his wife Krishna Insomnia, 25, and their daughter has spent year on his look, which is complete with 400 pounds fake fanged teeth, which he admits makes it difficult for him to chew. Tattoos cover 85% of Rico's body, while he also has 8 subdermal piercings, those placed under the skin, as well as a tongue split and his eyeballs tattooed. Number 9. Persecution. There is a great persecution of Christians that is coming. Of course, in many parts of the globe, extreme persecution of Christians has already begun. For example, did you know that Christians in China are regularly being arrested and taken to secret brainwashing facilities where they are tortured for months on end? For much more on this, please see my recent video entitled, "Where is the Outrage?" Every single day, Christians are being tortured, beaten and killed all over the globe. Number 10. Large numbers of Western Christians falling for end times deception. Here in the Western world, millions upon millions of Christians have been seduced by the feel-good Christianity that has taken over so many of our churches. Smooth-talking preachers promise their followers tremendous wealth and prosperity in this lifetime, and those preachers are assuring everyone that Jesus isn't coming back anytime soon. But the truth is that he is coming back. In Mark 13, Jesus specifically commanded us to watch for signs that he was coming back. For the Son of Man is as a man taking a far journey, who left his house, and gave authority to his servants, and to every man his work, and commanded the porter to watch. Watch ye therefore, for ye know not when the master of the house cometh, at even, or at midnight, or at the cockcrowing, or in the morning. Lest coming suddenly he find you sleeping. And what I say unto you I say unto all, watch. Unfortunately, large numbers of Christians in the Western world have not taken this warning seriously. Millions upon millions of them are dead asleep, and meanwhile end times events are literally in motion all around us. This was the Nomad Economist. Please like, share, leave me a comment, subscribe, and please take some time to subscribe to my backup channels. I do upload videos there too. You'll find the links in the description box. You will also find a PayPal link if you want to make a donation. Thank you wholeheartedly to all those of you who have already donated. Stay safe and healthy, friends.